Hello and welcome to episode 3 of Let's Play Civilization 6 Japan. In the last episode, we ran into this issue where the Sumerians are settling quite aggressively here here at Sipar. I'm still undecided if I want to attack them, but I think that seems to be the best solution. And but this city is just really badly situated, if I want to say it that way. I feel like it's going to take tiles away from my two other cities, but I might keep it if I were to take it. But we need to make a decision on them before they get their walls up. So here, my scout is here just waiting for me to research embarkation so I can embark it to explore the coasts. I think once the wall gets up, once I get my encampment up, I'm going to start building a military to take on the Sumerians, and we'll see how that goes. I mean, obviously, it could end up badly. But we are in a good position, relatively speaking, because we have no threats around us, except for barbarians down here. Okay, let's look at the war cart. Because that's probably what we'll be fighting against. They turn to knights, 30 melee strength versus what? Spearmen? 25. So they have an advantage on that one. But I think, does it say here war carts? I think there's still the rock paper scissors mechanic where a spears beat mounted units. I mean, I've felt it when I'm fighting with mounted units against spear units, but I don't think it explicitly tells you that. No penalties. Oh, but it has no penalties against anti-cavalry units. I'm pretty sure a spear are anti-cavalry. So that's 30 strength raw, and this is a yeah against a yeah. Okay, so the spears are effective against mounted units, but the war carts does not suffer from that penalty, so they have a 5 strength advantage over us. We'll have to figure something out. Maybe change one of our policies here towards more of a warring, more beneficial to us. So we'll have to figure something out here. It's not the best position to be in. And I spent so much gold buying up the land to block their expansion that I'd have no gold now left to upgrade my units. Looks like they're building a commercial district, if I were to understand that. Oh no, that might be their encampment district. That's not good. Let's get some chariots out. But at least they're not building walls where they're doing that. Greenery going here.
We're all apprentices in a craft when
catapults out. They're going to ask us about moving our troops pretty soon, I feel like.
Bom dia. É uma honra conhecê-lo pessoalmente. Parece que mentes brilhantes se atraem.
The Brazilians have been pretty much in every one of my games. I don't know why, but I think with that 16 or 15 starting civs, it's bound to happen when you're playing a larger map with 10 civs. But that's just how the way things go at the moment. Ignore the request. So we're not going to promise that we're going to move it away. That leaves us the option to not declare war, but we're not going to take that diplomatic hit for being a liar. But they're not going to like us for not promising that we're not going to attack them. So it's a nice way, I think, to hedge your bets. It's nice that the game lets you do that. Okay, they got their... Oh, they're building their walls. They're building their walls. We have to attack soon.
If it's natural to kill, how come men...
Okay, I gotta get this thing going soon. Jeez, the crossbows are super expensive. I can't afford to lose any of them. Let me see if I can switch to a policy that's advantageous to us. No, there's no policies right now that's good for us. So we'll keep that as is, because the build speed is going to help us build faster. Do a granary. Okay, let's do it. Well, yeah, they do outnumber us. So the audio cut out there because I hit escape as he was talking. I think that might be a bug, but okay, we'll see. Okay. What can we do? Stupid religious units, they need to move their ass out of the way. That scout there, it's gonna get attacked. Yeah, they're not gonna like us for declaring war. Seriously? These stupid religious units are blocking my attack. This is stupid. Move. This sucks. Come on. I can't move my catapults out because the units are blocking the way. Yeah, I don't like this. They need to fix it so that religious units can stack with military units. I mean, I'm generally I don't have any problems with one unit per tile, but the mechanics are so weird, especially when the AI is spamming these religious units, that it just gets in the way of things. Even if they park their units,
building blocks of the universe are fire.
If they park their units in your territory, it's even worse because. Really, you're getting hammered for things that you shouldn't be. Where's my war cart? Okay. Gonna get their walls up any turn now. That's not good. Too soon to attack. I'm gonna give it one more turn. Hopefully they don't get their walls up in time. Let's send that to Nagoya. Get a road up. Here they come. Okay. Walls are still not up, and we've got them under siege, which is good. Okay, objectives achieved. Well, I'll decide if I want to move on to the next goal here, but we will celebrate our achievement by keeping the city. We'll have to wait for the counterattack. Here to come.
If I were again beginning my study.
Get a galley out there. Once we deal with the counterattacks and we get more units out, we might be able to deal with their, think about... think about taking more territory. I'm really glad here that I didn't improve this, because that could have been pillaged. There's also a UI bug there. Sometimes you try to click a promotion, it doesn't go. I'll come back to it in a bit. Let's see if I can move this here. Okay, let's try that again. There we go. Yeah, that's definitely a bug. I mean, I'm glad if you're going to be throwing your war carts at us like that, I'm fine with that, because they're going to waste all your units doing that. Look, that's almost dead.
We can no more have exact religious...
Too bad, that's way too close. Could have killed that. See what else I'm gonna do. Naval units. Then we'll get another catapult up for this siege, because they have walls here. Yeah, they're retreating here. Upgrade this guy.
Gott grüße euch, Geselle.
Okay. We'll see how this goes. Might end badly for us, but so we're gonna build some extra spears back here. Catapult out. Spears are cheap to build. What I'm most worried about are my crossbows.
Imagine todas as conquistas surpreendentes que as mentes...
The only downside here is it's way too hilly here, so I need to get my units all around it to be able to attack it. Let's get a theater square up here. We're not getting good prices for our stuff right now. Okay, I don't. Yeah, this is. They're taking way too much damage. Let's see if we can make peace. Okay, looks like they're willing to give us a lot of stuff. Okay, they're not willing to do that. We already took the city, but they're going to cede it to us, so they're no longer going to treat it as a diplomatic issue in the future. Let's see how much gold we can get from them. Okay, not 20. 15, we'll take it. Let's end the war here. While we're ahead, and that will give me time to expand. Actually, in hindsight, Sipar's position might be good because I can build another campus district here, which to get a lot of science, and because of Japan's adjacency bonuses, it might be good to have all the districts all basically touching each other. So not too concerned about that right now. So let's get another settler up here. We're gonna settle up here. Okay. But at least our capital is safer. I just didn't like to have a city right next to my capital that can, you know, they can attack. So I have a buffer here now, and I can build another encampment from by Sipar here to block their route south. Have a scout here. Oh, there's an encampment here. Something for my military to do. Not a bad thing. So there's a lot of room here, and there's one source of iron, which I wouldn't mind having. Oh, they're gonna give us open borders for that. Okay. No gold.
Tactics mean doing what you can.
Oh, I guess I could send my archers in just to have a look here and see what they have going on there. Gonna do some shipbuilding stuff here. Oh, well, I waited too long for that encampment. The city-state took it. Send it back to Lisbon here, so we have more income coming in. Oh wait, what's my spearman doing here? He needs to go back. Actually, I'm gonna move my archers back. I'm gonna use my spearman to explore. He's more expendable. Oh, we got samurai. Okay. Oh, swordsman. When did we get iron? Was it part of our peace treaty? Yeah. Oh, might be from a city state. I don't see it on the map. So my goal here is to settle here and then fill up this spot here, all the way down here. I don't know how far I can do that until... until the AI starts filling it in for me, but if they were to settle down here, I should be able to cut them off really quickly, because what I'm more worried about is up here, because they can reinforce a lot quicker. If they have a lone city here, they'll be isolated, so I'm okay with that. Well, they do have room to expand up here. Oh, another coast. I see that could be new civ I haven't met. Red and yellow. Might be Spain, actually.
I cannot imagine any condition which would cause a ship defense is superior to opulence.
What's your next goal here? Let's go for education. Yeah, there's Madrid.
Ich verstore meine Feinde und ob ihr ihnen helft, auch ich.
Brazil, I think, is over here. I see the Sumerians' strategic problem. I think Germany's probably on this side here. We're here, and they're here. So they had to keep their forces on both sides. Because I was a little bit surprised that their defense was a little bit anemic. I wasn't expecting a huge attack, but it was less than I expected.
Yinek yiset izis hepertis epsen. Yinek Cleopatra hena henemeset ir. Iu ekshau.
Okay, Cleopatra. First time I've had her in my game. It's an honor to meet you. A lot of things to do here. First thing is I need to get a second campus district up to get more great people points going out and more research. Let's do that. And I want to buy a builder. Okay, so I think I'll end the episode here. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time.